What is up, guys? This is Michael C, and welcome to episode 8 of the Road to 800kg. For this video is going to encompass weeks 2 and 3 of this prep, or of this last block rather, leading up to the Grand Prix. And what I'm going to do is, obviously this is the introduction to where I'm just going to talk to you guys a little bit, because basically for these last few weeks I haven't really been too in the mood to talk to the camera, you know, like just stop training and just talk to the camera, because fatigue is a little bit higher now, and also just wanting to focus a little bit more for these sessions. So again, just haven't really been as in the mood to talk, so I apologize for that. But you know, I want to at least get on here and, you know, talk a little bit about my thoughts for the individual sessions and things like that. So what I'm going to do is, I have this introduction, obviously, and then for week two's training, I'm going to just show you guys the clips, the training footage, and then afterwards I'll come on and talk about my thoughts for the session and just how I felt going through the session as a whole. And then I'll go into week 3 and show you that footage, and then I'll do the same thing again, just come on again and talk to you guys afterwards, and that will be this video. And yeah, that'll be it for this video. So I hope you guys enjoy the footage as usual, and go watch it now.
Let's fight! My bag.
Yes, sir.
There you go.
So that was week two. So for this session, I had a squat single at 7 and a deadlift single also at 7. And going into this one, I had high hopes for the session. I hope that it went well, obviously. But once I started warming up and everything, I just felt really off on this day. Partially it might be fatigue, it also might be having to go to the bathroom and take care of business and all of that, but outside of that, you know, those weren't really major factors on this day, so I can't really say what it was, but I just didn't really feel well warming up for squats. I thought about it a little bit, and I think that part of it might have been that I had taken a pre-workout instead of taking a nootropic on this day. And like, I had just been kind of analyzing my sessions before this and leading up to this, and I had come to the conclusion that I generally did much better performance wise on the days where I took a nootropic versus the days where I took a pre-workout, because I'm already like hyper stimulated, so taking the pre-workout just adds to that stimulus even more. And I've come to the realization that for squats especially, I want to get hype and excited and everything, but I need to kind of keep it internalized. And you know, the sessions where I try to get like a little overly hype and I'm screaming before my sets and things like that, taking ammonia, I typically don't do as well under those conditions. And this is something that I've learned about myself after a ton of like just analyzing how I perform in different scenarios. And so I think that played a big part in it, which I'll get into, you know, going into the next week afterwards. And but anyway, yeah, this day, it just felt a little bit off for squats. I ended up squatting 270 kilos, 595 pounds at 7, which isn't terrible by any means. It's not bad, but it just, you know, it didn't feel as great as it probably could have. And I expected maybe a little bit more on this day, but again, by no means is that bad for a week two single, especially it was 7.5 kilos above what I hit for week one. So I mean, it's a good spot. It was a good spot to be in, all in all. And then back down volume felt super rough. And anyway, we're moving on to deadlifts. Deadlifts felt a little bit better. Probably because I got a little bit more fluids in my system. I was a little bit more warmed up. So deadlift warm-ups felt great. They were flying. And I knew that I would be able to hit something pretty nice. And so I did. I ended up hitting 295 kilos or 650 pounds at RP7. Which is for sure the best that I've moved that ever. It's only like the second or third time that I've pulled over like 290 kilos. So that was also a nice little part of the session too. So I felt really good about that. I've been feeling really confident in my pulls as a whole for throughout this prep. And so the confidence just keeps building for them. But anyway, I pulled that single and then I got the back down volumes. As you can see, the back downs again were really rough. My grip was warm because my calluses are all like swollen and tearing off my hands. So my hands are like tore up, and grip fatigue is a real thing. Like, especially if you do fingertip grip, which I do, I pull with fingertip grip. So when my hands get fatigued and grip gets harder and harder to manage, it can have an adverse effect on things, and you'll see that kind of affected week three a little bit. I won't go into that just yet. You'll see it after this. But anyway, back downs were rough, but we got through them, and then we had accessories, and then that was it for this day. And yeah, that was, I mean, it was a decent day overall. Can't really complain about it. And not much else to say about it. So without too much more delay, let's go on to week three.
Like the last one. Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah.
Just like that.
Yep. Up. Come on, finish.
Next week, I want to cover. All right, week three. So, as you can see, week three went much better overall. Felt much better overall than week two did, even though I was under a little bit more fatigue. So, things were still a little bit rough, but not nearly as bad as week two. And as I said before, instead of taking pre on this day, I took a nootropic, and as a result, I felt much better, felt much more focused and locked in, and so that played a big part in things feeling and moving a lot better. So I had a squat single, supposed to be at 7.5, and a deadlift single that was supposed to be at 8.5. So for squats, warm-ups were feeling like effortless, everything was feeling super good. And for the single, I ended up going up to 285 kilos or 628 pounds, and it moved very well, but I sunk it and I didn't really control it quite as much as I probably could have. So as a result, I tipped like way forward out of the hole, and you can see like it was a little bit weird coming out, but it didn't feel like on my back, it didn't feel hard, it didn't feel light, it didn't even really feel like I was grinding it when I was coming up with it. Like it was kind of one of those where it was like, okay, come on, any day now, but it didn't really feel like a grinder. Like it's weird, I don't really know how to explain it, but even though it wasn't quite a 7.5, it's nothing really to be mad about, because I knew that I would still be fine. I felt completely fine, and I'd be able to hit something more the following week, week four. So moved on to the back downs. The back downs were pretty straightforward, nothing crazy. I got through them without too much issue. They were they felt decently heavy, but they weren't too bad. Just looking at what exactly I had. I had 4x4 with 505 pounds, which rounded that up to 230 kilos or 507 pounds, and just got through those. And then moved on to deadlifts. This was, the lift, obviously, my last heavy pull of the prep. So the goal was to come in and pull something absolutely disgusting, which would end up being a PR for me. I pulled 302.5 kilos or 667 pounds before in this prep, the last block, I believe. And that was pretty smooth. So I wanted to pull something more than that, like something a little bit more. And I felt really good about pulls, like especially going through warm-ups, like everything was feeling effortless. Normally, I would jump from like 220 or 225 to like 255-ish, But today, like when things are feeling particularly good, I'll just skip that 255 and just go straight from 225 to 275. And so today was one of them days where I jumped straight to 275, and that 275 still flew as well. And then, you know, went from there, it kept going. And then eventually I got to 305, 672, which is the same weight. Well, technically, you know, it's 3 pounds less, but calibrated versus pound plates, whatever. Pretty much the same thing. It was the same weight that I missed at Alpha Elite a couple of months ago. And, you know, I got that about halfway up before dropping it. And with this, with the 672, you know, it was smooth. It didn't really feel too difficult, although my grip was like really making things more difficult. And I talked about that in my last little part, talking about week two, where my grip was starting to affect things a little bit, since my grip was more fatigued with dealing with higher intensities several weeks in a row. So you could see that, you know, I couldn't really hold on to things as much going through warm-ups as normal. So with the 305, even though it moved well, I had to kind of lock it out and drop it out as soon as I locked it out. And we ended up going up to 310 kilos or 683 pounds, which would have been another PR. And as you can see, unfortunately, I ended up missing it, partially due to my grip giving out, and also partially due to, you know, it just wasn't there on that day. Just under a lot of fatigue and just feeling beat up, and just wasn't there. But regardless of missing that, it was huge for me to be able to come in and hit 672 to end my heavy pulls. With that being 15 kilos over my best pull before nationals, which was 290 kilos, and it moved better than that did. So the way that my pulls show up on meet day, I think I've talked about this before, but normally my pulls tank under fatigue. So whatever I can pull in training under fatigue, you know, my heaviest pull leading up to a meet, I'm typically going to be good for a good 7.5 to 10 kilos over that, maybe even a little bit more than that on meet day. And that's not, you know, that's based off of, you know, previous meet history. Like, I've literally in the past pulled or missed like 255, 562 for my last single, and then ended up pulling 606, 275 kilos fairly easily at Raw Nats 2018, and other countless examples of it. But anyway, yeah, that's why I feel really good about this, about ending, you know, my heavy pulls off with that. So that's really all that I have for this episode. I think I've covered pretty much everything that I want to cover for this one. So if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys for the next one.